Hey guys, Dr. Jason Toronto. Great to be here. We are back, and today we are going to be talking about a real sensitive topic. It's going to be about principal chiropractors versus pain relief chiropractors. That's going to be the topic today. You guys know it's going to be a little bit hairy. We definitely have both sides of the spectrum in chiropractic. It's been going on for many, many years. Now's a great time to be able to talk about it. We know that it is a heated topic. The ICA just recently made some changes that caused a huge stir and causing people to kind of write letters about in what direction the ICA was going in. But what I want to talk to you about today is not regarding the specific philosophies, but what I want to talk about is which is going to be better when it comes to being able to practice, okay? So let's get talking about that, because I always love talking about money. I always love talking about practice and practice management, and that's why at Chirohacker Labs I try to be the greatest coach I can possibly be, and that's why I try to give you guys as much input and information that I've learned through my mistakes of practicing throughout the years. So look, so needless to say, whenever we talk about, principal chiropractors and pain relief chiropractic, we know that it creates a lot of emotion within the chiropractic profession. And although there's like tons and tons of opinions, no matter who you speak to, whatever seminar you go to, and there's always going to be different points of view, right? I mean, everybody has an opinion. When it comes to any type of business, in any type of business whatsoever, whether it's dentistry or whether it's chiropractic or whether it's the medical profession, but including chiropractic, what I value the most, what I really value the most are results. Results that are really going to be obtained in practice and not opinions. I mean, opinions are nice, they really are, but what I always try to do is I try to focus on results, and that's what you get from me. You get, results. I'm going to tell you if it's a good result, if it's a bad result. And really, I'm not that interested in theories, theoretical things, or I'm not really interested in the opinions of people or the hopes of people. Certainly, there's a lot of hope in chiropractic, or what people want chiropractic to be, or what they wish chiropractic to be. I'm just interested in what's happening, what's going on a day-to-day basis, and what the results and what the statistics are actually showing. And so, that through chiropractic, and the whole history of chiropractic, including what's going on today, a lot of chiropractors come out of school, and depending upon where they went to school, some of them are going to be really passionate about being, philosophically based chiropractors. I mean, we still have that today. We're in 2020, and we still have very philosophically based chiropractors, and that's okay, right? But we also have chiropractors who are getting out of school that are more pain relief type of a mindset, right? And so they think that those chiropractors that are principal, I mean, they believe in their mind, and believe me, I was there, because I went to New York Chiropractic College, graduated in 1992, and they were very, very philosophically based back then, if you can believe it, a New York school philosophically based. But they believed that the recipe for success back then was to kind of get away from the pain relief doctors and to get away from these so-called mixers, and come together and try to create within the profession an entire unification of chiropractors that were philosophically based and subluxation based. And I'm not saying that there's a problem with that, okay? Because, look, I still go to philosophically based seminars. I think I get a lot of help. I get a lot of good from them, right? But when it comes down to business, when it comes down to marketing, when it comes down to running a practice, I think that, human psychology, people's behavior, and success, I think it's crystal clear that thinking along these lines and running your business is probably going to be a problem. I think that it's flawed kind of thinking. I don't think it's accurate thinking. I don't think it is thinking that benefits most doctors. And I personally, and the reason being is because That type of thinking, these philosophically based, the philosophically based, right, and the people and your practitioners, that type of thinking is thinking that is not really consistent with what the community around you is looking for. Unless maybe you live on some type of kibbutz, or maybe you live out with the Mennonites over in Pennsylvania or something like that. But for the most part, today's public, they don't even know the philosophy of chiropractic. The community around you, they're not thinking along those lines. And so that type of thinking does not go along with what normal human behavior is thinking. And so I find that a lot of the principled chiropractors that I went to school with that are practicing right now, I find that, you know, when I get with them and we have lunch, right, they talk to me about chiropractic philosophy. But when I go to their practice to go see how they're running their business, I find that, well, you know what, it's not so philosophically based. And so, honestly, yeah, and the reason why I say that is because those guys are still billing out insurance. They're still putting down a diagnosis, which is other than vertebral subluxation. In fact, they're putting down a diagnosis to be able to maximize the amount of visits that they can get from whatever insurance it is that they're applying to. I see that these doctors are still treating symptoms inside their practice. People still go in for pain. Right, still brings them, you know, the pain. Yeah, they're still advertising pain. They're not advertising, do you have a subluxation in your back? They're advertising, do you have pain in your back? So they're addressing the pain. They're addressing symptoms, and they are, when they advertise, they are advertising that they are treating symptoms. And again, they're diagnosing and all those other things that you'd find a typical mixed doctor or pain relief doctor do. And so, to be honest with you, I don't really even think that the whole definition of principled chiropractic even means much today when it comes to running the particular business. And so, look, I don't get me wrong. There are practitioners out there that are philosophically based, that are very, very philosophically based, and they are not treating symptoms, and they are advertising vertebral subluxations, and they are talking the tick, and they are building practices. But I want you to understand that those people are far and few between. Like, those are real outliers in the profession. And you might have heard about those people. But trust me, there's very, very few of those people that have those high volume practices that are really getting paid what they're worth, you know, compared to other doctors that are trying to do that and are really failing at that. Okay? So why? Think about that. Why is it that there are so many chiropractors out there that are trying to run their practices with this philosophically based business principle, and they're struggling? Why is it? And it's very, very simple. It's because the community around you is not thinking along those lines. Your talk of tick, your talk of vertebral subluxation, you know, that's really falling to a deaf ear. Your community doesn't see that inside the community. And so their behavior is a different behavior than what it is that you're looking for. And you have to understand that in your community, there is no market for that inside your community. And you may be thinking, and you may be trying to sell a principled, philosophically based practice. And that is fine if you want to do that. But you have to understand that there really is no real market for what you think you're selling. There just isn't. And so you may find a very small, tiny market, but that is not what the masses want. And so where would you rather be? Would you rather be, marketing to a starving crowd, or would you rather be marketing to a very, very, very small crowd that isn't so hungry? Do you see what I'm saying? And so that is the reason why a lot of chiropractors that are philosophically based are struggling in practice. It's not that they're bad doctors. No, it's that their message is not the message that the masses are looking for. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't be a philosophically based chiropractor. That's okay. You can get patients into your office, and over time, after you've gotten them better, you can, and given them what they want, you can start talking the philosophically based, and you can start talking tick and things like that. Heck, after you've got them all better, if you want them to go to your lay lecture, you can have them do that as well. But initially, you've got to get your patients, you've got to give your patients what they want. So you've got to understand that the key to really building and maintaining a really smooth, sweet, beautiful practice over the long run is going to be able to get patients what they want based upon what their criteria is, not what your criteria is, right? You've got to give them what they want, and then you've got to build and nurture those relationships. So there are really six things that you have to consider, right? Six things that are in my ChiroHacker Lab program. And number one, it's you've got to properly position yourself in your community. And you want to position yourself as that doctor that is taking care of what it is that the masses are looking for. Right? The masses are not looking for philosophically vertebral subluxation-based doctors. They're just not. Number two, your office appearance, the doctor's appearance has to be spot on. You've got to be professional in every way, shape, or form. And even the way that you look. I mean, if you're a few pounds too heavy, you got to drop some pounds. I mean, you really you people come in, they look at your office, they look at you, and if you're not the right look, they may go elsewhere. Number three, really, you've got to have some clinical competency. You got to have the chops. You've got to be able to get your patients well. If you can't get your patients well, you know what? You're going to have a hard time in practice. But luckily, you can go to postgraduate seminars and you can gain clinical competency. That's something that you could actually work on. And number four, you've got to have systems inside your office that are duplicatable. Systems, you don't want to run your practice, off the cuff. You've got to have duplicatable systems that work over and over and over again. And number five, you've got to give patients what they want. You have to give them what they want. You can't give them what you want or what you think they want. You've got to listen to them. You've got to give them what they want. And then number six, over time, you've got to nurture. Once you build that, make that relationship with them, you've got to build that relationship with them, and you've got to nurture that relationship with them. You've got to nurture that relationship to the inactive and your active patients until they say, "Doc, stop contacting me." And that's the secret to success. So look, I hope you got some good information from this particular Facebook Live. Look, I don't say these things to be able to hurt anybody. Obviously, I just, it could, and I understand that, but that is not my intention. My intention is really just to help you in practice, to be able to build your practice and abundantly, and be able to share God's gift with those that are out there. So let me end this in prayer. Father God, I just thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to be able to share this information with those practitioners that are out there. Father God, I just hope that they can take this in the right way and they can use this information constructively to be able to build their practice and reach their goals. Father God, I pray that you give a blessing of abundance and abundant health and abundant prosperity to all those that are listening, Father God. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Guys, that's it. Girls, that's it. Hope you're having a great time. If you're having any difficulty in practice, you know what? The year is, we only have 153 days or something like that left inside the year. I wholeheartedly urge you, if you're getting stuck in practice, you want to just, maybe you just want to talk to somebody, you want to set up a quick chat, you can just press the message button below and we can talk for 2 or 3 minutes and maybe I can help you out. If you want to find out a little bit more about my program, you can go to chirohackerlabs.com. That's chirohackerlabs.com. That's it for today, guys. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.